Hello everyone, greetings from Kerala State IT Mission. Welcome to the video tutorial of Government of Kerala's e-procurement system. This tutorial clip provides the details and features about the project and its homepage functionalities. Let us get started. E-procurement project was launched on 7th December 2011 for increasing transparency and confidentiality in public procurement. Kerala government has mandated all government departments and PSUs in Kerala to adopt the e-procurement system for all tenders above rupees 25 lakhs. The project is being implemented by Kerala State IT Mission across the state. KSITM has taken extreme care to prepare the document as per prevailing rules and online process. However, if there are any contradictions in this tutorial, department officials or bidders are requested to bring it to the notice of Kerala State IT Mission's e-procurement team. The e-procurement website etenders.kerala.gov.in can be accessed online from any of the web browsers like Internet Explorer 8, Google Chrome or Mozilla Firefox. The basic requirements for using the e-procurement portal are a desktop or laptop, broadband internet connection, digital signature certificate DSE from a certifying authority recognized in India, DSE certificate drivers, JRE, Java runtime environment. Here we are going to show the various links found in the homepage and their uses. On the left side of the page, first option is MIS reports, which provides required data on all published e-tenders belonging to concerned departments or PSUs, bidder details, bid status, payment status, etc. This section can be accessed by clicking on MIS reports link and then logging in with your e-procurement login ID and password. This section is exclusive for department users. Next option is tenders by location. This search option is utilized by bidders to get active tenders, that is tenders which can be submitted, which applies to a particular location. To use this option, click the Tenders by Location button. Type the work location or item location of the tender and click Submit. Here, as an example, we will type Trivandrum as location. As we click on the Submit button, we will get the list of active tenders applying to Trivandrum location. Next option is Tenders by Organization. This search option is utilized to get active tenders published by a selected organization. To use this option, click on the Tenders by Organization button. Select the organization from the drop-down list. Click on the Show All checkbox and then click Search. Here, as an example, we will select Public Works Department. Click Show All checkbox and then Search. So, we will get all active tenders published by all divisions of PWD. Next option is Tenders by Classification. This search option can be utilized to get active tenders applied to a particular form of contract or tender schedule. To use this option, click the Tenders by Classification button. Select the required form of contract, that is item-wise rate, item rate or percentage rate from the classification list and then click on Submit. Here as an example, we will select the percentage rate from the classification list and click on Submit. We will get all active tenders which uses percentage rate as the form of contract. Mainly civil works published by PWD, irrigation department, etc. comes under percentage rate. Next option is tender status. This option is utilized by the public or bidders for getting the up-to-date status of the open tender. To use this option, click the tender status button. Type in the tender ID in the box provided or any other tender detail in appropriate box provided and then click search to get the up-to-date status. Here as an example, type in the tender ID 2013_PWD_11796_2 and click search. We get the tender detail with up-to-date status. When you click on the view tender button, a detailed page with all tender stage summaries will be shown. Next option is Tenders in Archive. This option provides the list of all expired tenders in the e-procurement system. Expired tenders include work awarded tenders or tenders whose bid validity date has already been passed. This option is used by public for getting required details of expired tenders. Next option is Cancelled Tenders. This option lists all tenders which are cancelled up to date by various registered departments and PSUs. This option is used for reference only. To use this option, click on Cancel Tenders button. Details of such cancelled tenders can be viewed from the Tender Status option. Next option is Downloads. This option lists all the necessary open source softwares and essential documents that can be used for successfully supporting the e-procurement system. To use this option, click the Downloads button. You will get a list of items which includes necessary software such as Java, PDF reader, digital signature drivers and essential documents such as BOQ templates, store purchase manuals, etc. Next option is Announcements. This option shows all e-procurement announcements that need to be conveyed to departments and bidders. For example, if a new functionality is enabled in our system or if the site is scheduled to go down for maintenance activities, necessary announcements will be published in this section so that the users could take a note of it. To use this option, click the Announcements button. Also, the same announcements are scrolled horizontally below the header. Next option is Awards. This option lists various awards or ratings received by the e-procurement portal. Next option is Site Compatibility. This option is used to check whether your system is compatible with the e-procurement system. For example, to use the e-procurement site, Java and browser cookies needs to be enabled. The general user can check whether both components are enabled in the local system to use the e-procurement site. Next option is the Latest Tenders section, which shows up to 10 latest published tenders. Hence, when a new tender is published by a department or PSU, the tender gets listed in the top position of this section. When you click More link shown below the section, you will get total active tenders published in the system. Likewise, there is a Latest Corrigendum section below the Latest Tenders section, which lists the latest active corrigendums up to 10 numbers. Next is User Login section, where department users as well as bidders log in to the e-procurement account, wherein tendering process is done. Tendering process includes tender creation, tender publication, bid submission, tender opening, etc. Also, below the login button, online bidder enrollment link is given, so that bidders can register by themselves by clicking on Online Bidder Enrollment link. Below this, there is Generate Forgot Password link, which can be utilized to reset their password if the account password is forgotten or if the account is blocked due to wrong password attempts. Next is the Tender Search box, wherein you can type the tender reference number, tender title, tender ID to search the required tender. There is also Advanced Search link, where bidders can search for tenders using multiple search options. To use this option, click the Advanced Search link located in the Tender Search box. You will get multiple drop-down lists such as Organization List, Division List, Subdivision List, Location, etc. Select appropriate values from each list so as to get active tenders published by a particular section of a department or in a particular location, etc. And then click Submit to get the list. For example, if you need to search only tenders published by CEINDA SCISC Trivandrum section of Irrigation Department, select the required section in Organization and Division List and then click Submit. Next is a help for contractors which lists all special instructions to be followed by contractors or bidders for bid submission. Then information about DSE button, which provides necessary information about DSE's addresses for purchasing the DSE. Next is the bidder manual kit, which has all the details for submitting bid. Next is home link in return to the home page if needed, and then contact us link for e-procurement help desk contact information. That is all about the basic details of e-procurement website. Thank you for listening to this video tutorial.